1, 2, 3, 4.
I've walked among the shadows. You wiped my tears away. And I've felt the pain of heartbreak. And I've seen the brighter days. And I break rest to heaven from my lowest place. And I have held the blessings, God, you give and take away. No matter what I have, your grace is enough. No matter where I am, I'm standing in your love. On the mountains I will bow my life to the one who set me there. In the valley my dreams get broken. In you I hope again. No matter what, I know I'm safe inside your hand. On the mountains I will bow my life to the one who set me there. In the valley I will lift my eyes to the one who sees me there. When I'm standing on the mountain I didn't get there on my own. When I'm walking through the valley, no, I am not alone. You're God of the hills and valleys. Hills and valleys. God of the hills and valleys, yeah. But I am not alone. Father, you give and take away every joy and every pain. Through it all you will remain. Over it all, Father, you give and take away every joy.
Bleed.
Only the power of Christ compel you.
Tell me, who are we to judge someone by the kind of clothes they're wearing or the color of their skin? Are you black? Are you white? Are we all the same inside? Father, open our eyes to see we all bleed the same. We're all beautiful when we come together. We all bleed the same. So tell me why, tell me why we're divided. If we're gonna fight, let's fight for each other. If we're gonna shout, let love be the cry. We all bleed the same. So tell me why we're divided.
Only love can drive.
I've been on this trip a few times, so I'm pretty much an expert in Navajo culture. No, that isn't true. But I do know a lot about their customs. So if you come here, you eat last. My favorite part about this mission trip was how easy it was. We were inside most of the time, which is great because it gets so hot here, but not as hot as at home.
The best part about this trip was definitely playing cards with Danya, Cameron, and sometimes Matthew during our free time on this trip, because it would definitely keep your adrenaline going and you would always be super excited because it's really fast, and compared to all the work that we've done that day, it's just nice to, you know, relax and not have to worry about messing up because it's just a game.
Navajo culture, I mean, is very different from our own. Like it seems like a lot more traditions from ancient times passed down rather than them fading away, which is interesting. Like, for instance, I'm not wearing mine now, but there's a necklace that, says they give you protection against disasters and whatnot. Well, we haven't been to the lake yet, so it's probably going to be the lake, but if it's not, then it's probably just playing cards, so it's probably the most fun.
What have you been playing?
Most of the time we play speed. I'm not that great at it, but it's still really fun because you have to go fast. You also have to think, and I'm not good at thinking fast.
Okay, so this trip has been significantly easier than the past two trips that I have taken. And I know it sounds weird because we put in flooring, which was kind of a pain in the butt, but the people that needed it really needed it. Diana, she needed the flooring. And so it wasn't that bad when we had everyone working together, but at least we weren't cleaning up a whole rubble pile. And also, there was a lot less youth children that came. As you guys know, it was two boys and two girls. And it was me and Matthew, and we're seniors this year. And then it was Helen and Cameron, who are freshmen this year. So everything kind of worked out perfectly. And cleaning the bathroom was a lot easier. Not worrying about, you know, shower times, thank God, was a lot easier just because there were less people. And we all got along really, really well. One thing that I learned specifically on this mission trip was probably just the same things that I learn every mission trip. It's kind of like, I kind of need the mission trips every year because they teach you about, you know, being grateful for what you do have and then being accepting of other people's cultures and learning about other people and how they speak and how they live, which is very, very different than you. And especially, you know, like the Navajo tribe and like how they treat each other, and then coming back to California and seeing how people treat each other, it's a lot different. We don't treat each other like family, and that was a huge thing. And I feel like you take this mission trip and then you come back home for like a month and then you remember all this stuff and you're really grateful and things, but then we forget, you know, life-changing things that's happened to us. And with work and school and having to take care of, you know, everyone else and trying to keep up with your self-care too, you can forget simple things like what you learn on the mission trip. And it's important to come back every year, so that's why I try to encourage as many kids in our youth group to come on mission trips. Even if you've been on trips before, mission trip is different because you're with your church group and you're you're helping people. Like, these things need to be done. So I think that was the most important thing. That part of this trip, excluding the finishing everything that we needed to get done and then seeing everybody be happy, would be the card playing that we did. It was really intense. There was a lot of yelling, and I've heard Cameron make sounds that I didn't think a human girl could make, and I've heard Helen make sounds that I didn't know a human girl could make. So everything gets really intense, but this is our last day. We're leaving tomorrow, and I'm glad that everyone came that came, and I'm ready to have a fun last day.
So we've had a good week here. It's been very enjoyable from the beginning. The kids have been great. It was a joy watching them put that floor together and do the painting. And we learned a lot from the medicine man and continue to grow our relationships with the people here, and I can't wait to come back. And I challenge everybody to do some kind of service, because it's just very spirit-filling, and at least for me, brings me a lot of joy.
For me, mission trip is all about relationship. It's about watching the relationship between the kids get stronger. It's about our relationships with the kids getting better, and it's about our developing relationship with the Navajo folks here. After 6 years, it's really wonderful to have familiar faces welcoming us and glad to see us when we come back. It's a very special place for me.
Most years when we've come here to Navajo Land on our mission trip, I felt really confident about the jobs we were asked to do, because mostly we've been doing some painting, and the infamous rubble removal took no skill, just a lot of muscle. But this year we were asked to do flooring, and I had never put in laminate flooring. Thankfully, both Christina and Sherry had some experience in such a thing. And we made Deanna and her family so grateful to put some laminate flooring in their living room. It looks like an entire new room to them. And in fact, Jaden said last night he slept on the couch in there so he could sleep in his new living room instead of in his bed. We have again had a great trip here to Navajo Land and met a lot of the folks that we've worked with and gotten to know over the years. I don't think next year Reverend Chan will be here. I think she will have moved on as the clergy here move and change from year to year. But the most remarkable thing is really the transformation in the hospital and the new rooms that are going up and all of the plans they have here for a teaching kitchen and a storytelling room and a web design farm. And it's just amazing. And what they keep saying to us over and over and over again is, we couldn't have done it without you. And the truth of the matter is, we couldn't do it without you either. So thank you so much again for your support and your care this year as we've prepared to go on mission trip. We had two old hands in Matthew and Danya, and two new ones in Cameron and Helen, and everyone pitched in as they always do. And we have been such a blessing to the people here, and you have been such a blessing to us. Thanks a lot.